Sit down, we need to talk. When was the last time you saw a swoosh transition, speed ramp, or any transition in a film? I'm waiting, take your time. Look, cinema has cuts, oops, dissolves, fade outs, and fade in. That's pretty much it. Star Wars used wipe transition, and even that was too much for some people. You know what is cinematic? L cut and J cut. It's when audio continues the next shot or the previous one. I love it, it's a great tool to connect scenes. Then let's talk about the characteristics of cinematic editing. Not YouTube style, no. I will give you 10 basic ideas, cinematic cuts, but they are very fundamental. Tip number one, cutting on action. Hollywood invented this in 1900s and called it invisible editing or continuity editing. And then they created these wonderful films because it creates a seamless transition, seamless flow. The viewer's eye seamlessly follows the action from one shot to another. Otherwise, it would look a bit jumped. The next technique is matching cuts. This creates visual continuity by cutting between shots with compositional overlaps. Ew. So matching movement, color, shape, or framing helps smooth out edits between shots. The third one is to use shot and reverse shot. This basic editing pattern is the backbone of dialogue scenes. Cut back and forth between facing shots of two characters to create conversation. But you can add some flavor, you can show listener's face as well. Also, you can use over the shoulder as well as a single shot. As you can see now, they better should be pre-planned because you cannot just create shots out of nowhere. Next up, matching motivated movement. This means cutting from one shot to another that has matching motion or directionality. Someone walking from left to right, in the another shot, the same thing continues. It provides a visual logic that smooths out the edit. But these are not rules, you can always change them to give a different meaning, different feeling. Being lost, for example. Number five is cutaways, but not like in The Family Guy. You need to enhance a scene, then you can cut away to insert shots of objects or actions related to that scene. Close-ups of hand opening a letter, changing a lens, making a ways. This adds richness without interrupting the flow. Then let's get rhythmic. Editing has a rhythm, like music, and trust me, most directors keep music in mind when shooting the footage. And editors generally try to use a piece of filler music to understand the rhythm. Use the pacing of cuts to deliver the mood and energy of the scene. Quick cuts convey excitement and slow dissolves might mean melancholy. And vary the rhythm over the course of a scene to shape emotions. Number seven, parallel editing. Intercuts back and forth between two scenes happening simultaneously in different places, like a heist movie. This builds suspense and tension by cross-cutting the action, a classic technique used in action films. Number eight, fades, wipes. Not this wipe, that one. They are stylistic and meaningful transitions. They generally show passing time or changing location, but don't overdo it because they feel distant and the audience will wake up from the cinematic dream. We don't want it unless we are making an art house film. 9. Jump cuts. Before Godard did it, it was a mistake. Now in YouTube era, it is widely used, so I don't know, use it if you like. 10. My favorite because it's about sound. L cuts and J cuts. These create seamless transitions between scenes because it is when the audio continues to the next shot or the previous one. Let's hear some. So there you have it, 10 editing not really secrets used by everyone. Let me know which ones are your favorites and hope to see you in another video. Thanks for watching. See you later. Yeah, I cut some pieces of 35mm Lord of the Rings footage. Yeah.